top, Nathan. Can Josh Brown do that again?
I hope so. It was incredible last night. Really pleased for him and obviously for us as a team to have someone that could come out and hit the ball that cleanly, that often. So fingers crossed he's left a few more in him for tomorrow night. Yeah, I'm fortunate enough to play a lot of club cricket with Brownie growing up in Queensland. So I've seen it before, but for him to do it on a big stage like that, incredibly happy for him. And yeah, as I said, I hope he's got a few more in him tomorrow.
You spoke at the airport this morning and credited yourself to his form, your captaincy and calmness that you give. What have you been saying to him? How do you get that out of him?
Yeah, I think just having someone down the other end that he's batted a lot with, and it certainly helps me batting with someone familiar down the other end. So I just try and keep him calm. And the other night when we played the sixes, it was quite a tough wicket, and you know, there's a fair bit of pressure on him to go out and hit the ball hard like everyone knows he can. So I just try to make it really clear that you just watch the ball hard and keep it really simple, and when he does that, he can hit the ball for six and all over the ground, which I think is a real strength of his. He doesn't just target one area in the ground. He can hit it over cover, which we saw last night, and he can also hit it miles over mid on. So yeah, hopefully he can just keep hit the ground running again on Wednesday. Yeah, I assume so. Cooper cricket would be going nuts.
In the past, we've seen, I think, Craig Simmons, Luke Combs, have gotten on really good runs at the right time of the year. Do you think Josh can do something similar? I know it's a team sport, but if one guy gets one at the right time, can he take you all the way?
Yeah, I think in T20, that's all it takes. One of those guys to go off and can win you a game. So they're a definite match winner. Yeah, obviously, he's done it on a big occasion, being last night, and there's no doubt in a final, it's a big occasion, but I think he can do it again for sure. Along with the other batters in our team who have been incredible throughout the year. We haven't just relied on one bloke. We've all contributed at certain times in the year. So if it's not Brownie's night, hopefully it's one of the other batters.
Nathan, with the Gabba pitch being a lot like fast and bouncy, and then you go to the SCG and it's been very slow paced, how do you adapt to that change?
Yeah, I think it's probably a blessing in disguise. We've played the last couple of games at Metricon down the Gold Coast, which is probably similar to the conditions where we get here rather than the Gabba. So I think our planning will be pivotal today and what it has been over the last couple of days, getting used to those slow tracks and no doubt get a game plan that we think can win the game.
Has Charlie given a final message yet before the final?
Nah, not yet. I'm sure he would have whipped up something on the plane and be ready to deliver us a message. I think his message last game was just to be positive and be brave. I feel like in big games, some of us probably just went into our shell a little bit. And his message would just go out there, take it on, and if we do that, we give ourselves the best chance to win.
That said, out the wicket, do you bring Swepson back in, or do you sort of keep Charlie Wakeham on top?
Yeah, I haven't had a look at it today. I'm sure the coaches, myself, and we'll probably make a decision later on today. So we'll just have to wait and see.
What do you take out last year, mate? Does that extra viability going into tomorrow night?
Yeah, I think a lot of the boys playing tomorrow would have played last year in that final. Obviously, being so close and losing in a close one hurts, and it hurts for a long time. So it's definitely in our minds. I think it carried its weight throughout the year. We've really been focused from throughout. We prepared well. We know what it takes to get there, and hope we're there now, and just trying to one more game to finish off. Nothing different. We've played really good cricket throughout the year, so hopefully we can just, on a big occasion, just stick to our guns and play the way we can, because that'll be good enough.
Do you think, are there things, even just tactically or psychologically, that can be taken out of playing the final? It's always the adage, you got to lose one to win one. Do you subscribe to that?
No, not really. My dad always used to say that, and I've lost a couple now at the finals throughout the last couple of years, so hopefully I'm due to be on the right side of one.
I know you're not sort of in the list management decisions, but do you take a lot of confidence, I guess, out of that and seeing the Sixers and the Scorchers have such a stable base? A lot of your guys played last year, come in without the internationals. Do you sort of take that going forward as the blueprint to success and sustained success?
Yeah, I think so. I think the list managers have done a terrific job keeping a core group of players that have played for a long time for the Brisbane Heat, and along with a couple of new guys who are just starting to get that experience. So I think the longer, you know, we can keep that core group of players, winning's fun, so it helps keeping everyone involved. So hopefully we can win a comp on tomorrow night, and I'm sure that will continue to keep that core group of players for a long time.
One of those players is Xavier Bartlett. He's been outstanding and got the call up for the ADI squad. Just a couple of words on him and what's impressed you most about him this season?
Yeah, I think he's played for a few years now in the Brisbane Heat. I think his work ethic's unbelievable. His willingness to learn, and then coming into a big bash where he hasn't played any cricket before, he missed the start of the Shield season through injury, and to hit the ground running like he has and to have the confidence he is at the top of his mark at the moment. It's incredible to see. And as a captain, you know, when you give him the ball, you know he's confident and he's calm and he's got to deliver. So super happy for him and pleased that he's got the call up to play for Australia. You know, that's a credit to him and his hard work. And he's one of those guys in the squad that everyone just loves. So everyone's chuffed for him, and hopefully another good performance on Wednesday, and then we get to see him in a couple of days later play for Australia.
Nathan, the Sixers beat you in the qualifier, but what can you do differently to beat them in the final? Can you go that one step further?
Yeah, I think a lot of the players played in the game out here last year where we needed to beat the Sixers to get into the final. And credit to Michael Nessa and Matt Kuhneman, who had a terrific game last year. So I think we know what it takes to win here. We've done it before, so there's no reason why we can't do it tomorrow night. It's just about putting aside the final and the occasion and whatever comes around, and just try and focus on what we can control. And if we do that, it gives ourselves the best chance, and hopefully we can get across the line.
You're going up against the most experienced BBL captain. How have you found the leadership, and what have you learnt in that short period?
I've had plenty of good help along the way. Usman Khawaja, Sam Billings, Colin Munro, Marnus, Jimmy Pearson, they've all been excellent for me. I've just tried to be a sponge in the change room for the last couple of years. And after the first two games, I was wondering if I'm the right man for the job. But it was good to get a win last night, and constantly learning. And no doubt I've got plenty to learn from Moses. So hopefully our team at the moment can kind of run on cruise control, really. They've been excellent all year. So a few slight tweaks and changes maybe, but I think it's pretty comfortable team to captain at the moment, and hopefully another good performance.
Were you always aware you get the reins back in the season of finals?
No, not really. Probably when we knew that we got a finish in first in that last game in Perth, the coach pulled me aside the day before the game and said I was got a captain. I've done it a lot growing up as in the junior pathway, and vice captain of South Australia. So I think they thought that I've captained a couple of games in Australia as well. So I think they always knew that I could be an option. But to get the nod, and incredibly privileged and fortunate for the opportunity, and I can't wait to run out and being captain of the Brisbane Heat in a final. It's pretty special, and really lucky.
And do we know if Josh's mum's got tomorrow for her? Did she fly down? That was a big deal last
night. I don't know. I think she goes everywhere. She came to Perth last year, so I'm sure she'll be here. That's for sure.
Had you been in like the strategy sort of selection meetings prior to that, or was it sort of all lumped on you coming into that game in Perth?
Yeah, probably four or five games before I got added into the strategy meeting. So it was probably in the back of my mind. But yeah, just sitting in them, not saying a word, and just listening to the brains of like Darren Lehman as well, who I missed out earlier. I've been excellent for my cricket and obviously tactically. So hopefully can get the make the right choices.
Have you found the step up in intensity of like pulling the strings compared to say, you know, the Aussie A stuff in the first class games?
Yeah, T20 games, obviously there's a bit more weight on every decision because it happens really fast. Whereas a 4-day game kind of can pan out slowly. So yeah, I think, along as I said before, it kind of runs itself at the moment, the team. The bowlers know when they've got a bowl. It's been set out for me pretty clearly. So, it's not too bad of a gig, to be honest.
Nathan, the crowd's been up this season, the viewership's been up. Have the players been feeling the love for the competition, and are you able to pinpoint why it's been such a success this season?
Yeah, definitely. I think the Gabba crowd has been excellent all year for us, and Metricon, we sold that out against the Sixers in that first final. So it definitely helps as a player. It's why you train, it's why you do the hard work to try and play in front of a crowd. It's where you want to perform. So we're very lucky to have the support we do in Brisbane. I heard tomorrow's got to be pretty close to being sold out as well, so it's awesome. That's why we play the game. We're really looking forward to it, and along with that, it's about controlling what we can control and take it all in, because it's a special occasion. But hopefully play really well in front of a hostile crowd, it could be, or a full house away.
Nathan, while Josh Brown was smacking it all over the park last night, his old man didn't move from the same position he was in. Are you as superstitious as his family?
Yeah, I think cricketers are a bit funny like that. Certain coaches say if someone's batting, you can't move seat. I try not to be, because it becomes a pretty hard space when you're sitting down, you can't do anything. So I think my parents are similar. I think if you're a parent watching a game, you're obviously really nervous. I know his family really well, and they'll be super proud of his efforts, and hopefully he can stay in his seat for a while on Wednesday.
I asked Moe, a light-hearted one, about this final, unlike last year, there's a bit of a State of Origin feel to it. I won't tell you what he said, you'll have to ask me. Do you hate, as a Brisbane boy, do you hate the Sixers?
No, not really. It's not the same as State of Origin. It's a little bit different in the cricket sense. But yeah, obviously it's always nice beating New South Wales as a Queenslander. And to do it in Sydney would be even better for sure.
Thanks, mate.
Queenslanders get BBL.